Hey guys, it's Monday, and today's workout is called Wonderworld. You've got a four-time workout today, and you're going to complete 21 double dumbbell clean and jerks, all weighted with like a bag, clean and jerks, then 100 double unders. You're then going to do 15 weight clean and jerks, then 100 double unders, then 9 clean and jerks, and then you're going to finish it off with another set of 100 double unders. The aim of today is to get this done in around 15 to 25 minutes. In terms of the clean and jerks, what we want to do is try and find a weight where we can complete them in steady singles or big sets, and then the last few reps, singles. Ideally, you'd stick with single reps for the whole thing because it is a moderate weight. And that allows you to move onto that skipping rope and get those done in one to two sets, ideally unbroken. And then towards the latter of the workout, you might need to break the skipping up a little bit more, but those consistent singles will allow you to get more reps done in the skipping. So, let's get warm. We're gonna start off with our skipping ropes for a minute of single unders. In 3, 2, 1. Last 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Nice work, everybody. All you do now, jump into some active Samsons for a minute, interlocking those fingers, bringing our arms above our heads, and we come into a nice deep lunge. Holding this for a second or two, come back up and swap over. Really stretching those hips and shoulders off. Really pulling those hands behind our heads. Three, two, one, and relax. All we do now, we can go to single leg glute bridges. We'll do 30 seconds on each side. Keep that one leg out straight, raising our hips to the ceiling. And 5, 4, 3, 2, and change legs. Ten seconds. 4, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back onto our feet. We're now going to do the next three movements for 40 seconds rather than a minute. We're going to do 40 seconds of double taps. So I'm going to jump The aim is to get both taps in before I start falling back to the floor. Like that. So, for 40 seconds in, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You said it has to be super fast. The aim is just to get both taps in before we start falling back down. That's 10. Five, four, three, two, one, and relax. Shake those legs off. I'm gonna jump back down to the floor. I'm gonna go for push-up to downward dogs for 40 seconds. So, what I'm gonna do, send those elbows back, chest and thighs touching the floor. I'm gonna push up, come into that downward dog position. I've got this for 40 seconds. You can drop to your knees if you need to. Makes that push up a little bit easier. Now 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Well done, everyone. It's quite a tiring warm up, isn't it? What we're going to do now, come back onto our backs. I'm going to do glute bridge walkouts for 40 seconds. So, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, set those hips to the ceiling, walk out 2 steps, 2 more, back in, down. Making sure those hips are at the ceiling the entire time. Three, two, one, and back onto our feet. All we're going to do now, we're going to go for a real quick weighted warm-up, get some mobility and teaching, and we'll get into that workout. So, all I want to do, I'm going to grab that bag, hold it by our chest, and we're going to go for 5 good mornings. Soft knees, hinging those hips, nice neutral spine, bring that chest parallel to the floor, make sure we squeeze at that top. 2, 3. We're now going to go to 5 goblet squats. So, holding top of that weight, keeping it, using it as a counterbalance to pull us forwards, very similar to the front squat. Elbows, don't have to be quite as high as that front rack position, just holding that weight in front of our chest. Send those hips back and down for 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nice. Into our front rack, we're then going to go for 5 strict presses, moving that head back right to the ceiling. Once we've done that, we're going to come to the floor, and we're going to go for 5 remaining deadlifts. The bag will come to the floor, we're not going to go to the floor. Soft hips, soft knees, hinging those hips to about mid-chin, driving back up. And then last one, 5 front squats. Bring that weight as high as we can. Use that front rack, getting our elbows nice and high. We get 5 reps like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nice work, everyone. Popping that weight down for now. I'm going to start off with a front rack stretch. We're going to hold this for 30 seconds. All I'm going to do is going to lie down on that floor. I'm going to walk my elbows out forward and bring my hands up and praying above my head. My head, I've only got one. Once our elbows are walked out and our hands are behind our head, we try and pull our armpits to the floor. And that'll really stretch out your shoulders and your thoracic. Really good for that front rack position. We've got this for 30 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. Slowly ease up. Nice work. All we do now is come into a forearm stretch or a wrist stretch. All I'm going to do, have my hands in front of my knees, and I'm just going to try and lean my shoulders past my fingertips. You can bounce on this, just try not to push too far. As soon as you feel a bit of pain, that's where you should be stopping. You're going to bounce around that area. Five, four, three, two, one. Shake those wrists off, turn those hands around. We're going to do the exact opposite now. Trying to tap our bum to our toes. Don't worry if you can't get there. I still can't. It is quite an aggressive stretch on that inside of your forearm. The closer your hands onto your knees, the easier this stretch will be. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and ease off there. One. All we do now, jump to our feet, we're going to grab ourselves our skipping ropes. We are going to go for 30 seconds of single under practice. Once you've done that, we'll take a 5 second break and go into 30 seconds of double under practice. In 3, 2, 1, 30 seconds of singles. Really want to focus on using those wrists to get that rope around. Center. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. All we do now is go for 30 seconds of double under practice. If you can't do that, don't worry, go for 30 seconds of double taps. In 3, 2, 1, off you go. Wonderful start. Now, we're going to grab our weight now. So, if you have got 2 dumbbells or 2 kettlebells, use them. If not, grab yourself a weight pack and we will do it just the same as this. So, I'm going to start off with 5 high hang power cleans. All I'm going to do, nice soft knees, keep that chest up, my shoulders are behind the weight. I'm going to try and jump that weight into the air, pull myself under it, and we'll catch it in that power clean position. One. Two. Three. Four. And five. Once we've done that, we're then going to go to the hanging position. So I'm going to dip, hinge the top of my knee. All I'm going to do is reverse it to come back into that high hang, jump one more step under. We're just going to give ourselves a bit more momentum to get that weight up. So, dip, hinge, and clean. One. Two. Three. Four. Last one. Five. Nice work, everyone. All we do now, go for five full power cleans. So, coming into that dip, I'm going to hinge and then I'm going to sink into almost a squat so that weight touches the floor, keeping those shoulders nice and pinned back. The exact same thing that I just did with that hang to high hang difference. So, nice slow deadlift to the knees. Once we get there, we're going to explode back into that high hang and pull ourselves into that weight. Just like that. So, we've got five reps. One, dip, in, two. Make sure that deadlift is nice and slow. Three. Four. And five. So, that is the cleans for today. We have also got jerks. So, we're gonna start off with five strict presses. Elbows nice and high. Send that head back, weight to the ceiling. Nice work. Once we've done that, we're going to come into a push press. So all we want to do is use our hips just like we do in that high hang, where we jog that weight up, driving through our hips. We do the exact same thing. Come to a little dip, pop our hips, use that to get the weight off our shoulders and then finish the push off. So, with me, dip, and drive, there's one. Dip, drive. Dip, and drive. Dip, and drive, that's one. Dip, and drive. Nice work. All we're gonna do now is go into some push jerks, and then we'll finish off with three clean jerks. So, back into that position, that front rack position, I'm going to dip, push, and then rather than finish it off with my arm, I'm going to drop under it again and catch it, just like this. So there's one. Cool, we've got five reps. So, with me, dip, drive, there's one. Two, really use those hips. Three. Four, that's one. Five. Well done, everybody. Whew, I'm getting a bit sweaty, so hopefully you are too. All we're gonna do now is go for three cleaning jerks. So I'm gonna bring that movement together, well, those two movements together, because that is what we have in the workout. So, starting off with that power clean from the floor, nice slow deadlift. I'm gonna explode, come under it, finish it off in the jerk. There's one. We've got two left. And last one. And relax. Nice work, everyone. So, our workout today is called Wonderworld. For time, you've got 21 double dumbbell cleaning jerks or weighted cleaning jerks, then 100 double unders. Once you've done that, you're going to move into 15 weighted dumbbell cleaning jerks or weighted cleaning jerks, sorry, then another set of 100 double unders. You're then going to go on to your last weighted movement, which is 9 weighted cleaning jerks, and you're going to finish off with 100 double unders. Take this time now to pause the video, go to the toilet, grab yourself a drink, have 2 minutes rest, come back. We'll go through the workout again and we'll get into it. So, one final time, your workout today is called Wonderworld. For time, you're going to complete 21 double dumbbell weighted clean and jerks, or just weighted clean and jerks, then 100 double unders. You're then going to do 15 weighted clean and jerks, then another set of 100 double unders, then a set of 9 clean and jerks with a weight, obviously, and a final set of 100 double unders. With the 100 double unders, if you don't have double unders, you have a couple of options. So we can either do 200 single skips. If that does get too much, we can lower it down to 175 or 150 if needs be. The 100 double unders or 200 single skips, or whatever variation you choose, should not be taking you any more than 2.5 minutes. So if you want to practice double unders, what you can do, you can go for single, double. Just try and teach yourself those double unders in the workout. Do it for a minute, 2.5 minutes. Once you've done those double unders, all that practice for the 2.5 minutes, stop. Go on to the next set of weighted movements, and then when you next get back into the double unders, do it for another 2.5 minutes. Just use it as a bit of practice. Hopefully that made sense. So when you're ready, in 3, 2, 1, go.